Hey guys, this is Jasu, and welcome to Shadowverse, Tempest of the Gods. The new expansion set is upon us, and so to celebrate the occasion, I've decided that I'm going to do a little pack opening for you guys. I don't know how many of you guys who follow the channel even care about this game or know anything about it, but nevertheless, I've been really excited for this new set for a while. I'm a big Shadowverse fan, I alluded to that a little bit in my videos in the past, and so I don't know, I felt like putting a video up, so we're gonna do a big Tempest of the Gods Day 1 pack opening video for you guys. I've been saving up my gold for a little while, and I think that Cygames is about to dump some free packs. How many are we gonna get? We get 10 free packs. That's like not even for anything. It's just for free. Just have it, you guys, because just give you all the free stuff. So yeah, between that and the gold I got up here, I think 30 packs should be good. I'll save my 200 gold for, I don't know, other packs later on and outside of video. I feel like 30 is going to be a lot. This is not going to be completely blind. I followed the spoilers for this set for like the first few sets of spoilers they sent out. So it's like, I don't even remember what they were at this point. They've been putting out so many spoilers for this. And eventually, yeah, they put out the spoilers so frequently and just so many of them that I just stopped keeping track because it was just like, couldn't handle it all. It was too much. So it's just, yeah, I think I paid attention to like the first three that they put out and I've forgotten about them by now. So this is going to be pretty close to a, just blind reaction to whatever nonsense they're going to throw at us. So, okay, I guess I've got 11. Oh, right, I think I earned one from, like, laddering on the previous month. So, okay, we're gonna get 11 packs off the bat. Oh, apparently we can only do 10 at a time? Okay, fine, we'll do 10 off the bat. And let's see what we get here. I think I'm gonna go through the slow way. You can skip this and it'll just show you all the cards at once, but I don't know. I'm a bit superstitious about this. I've had better luck with legendaries not hitting the skip button. And it looks like we got a lot of, okay, this is, I remember I saw this one talked about a lot on the Reddit, a whole bit, the lightning blast. We'll get to that in a bit. So we got a Shrouded Assassin. I don't think I know what that is. It looks like a forest. Oh, it's sword. Ambush Bane. Ooh, I like ambush. I've been trying to make an ambush deck work. Except, you know, it's not quite enough pieces there for it. So this Ambush and Bane, that's a good combo too. Because, yeah, the problem with Bane often is it just gets removed before you can use it. But Bane and Ambush, yeah, that's pretty cool. What's she sound like?
Death from the shadows.
Nice.
So long.
Cool. Yeah, I like that one. 4 cost. It is a little bit expensive. But for Ambush and Bane, I think it's worth it. It's basically overcost. Yeah, it's like a 3 cost stats, and then for 1 extra you get Ambush and Vayne. Not too bad. Wise Merman, it's a neutral, and it gives +1 to an allied neutral. I've actually got a neutral deck that this'll slot into pretty easy. In fact, I think this is basically just gonna be a straight replacement for Goblin for me in that deck.
All my wisdom for you.
That guy's got a goofy voice.
Fascinating.
I actually do have my game switched over to the Japanese voices and graphics, but obviously I haven't done it yet for the new set, but oh wow, this guy gets like a bunch of stuff on him. I always like it when they like radically transform the artwork for the evolved form. But yeah, that's honestly not an amazing card, even for a neutral deck, but whatever, we're gonna have to pick this up, because yeah, 30 packs, my goodness. It's, okay, 6 for a 4-4 rush. Okay, so this is a Haven thing, so it's basically just a better version of, I forget what it is, it's like Greater Priestess or something, it's like the 6 cost Haven unit that subtracts 1 from all of your allied amulets, or maybe it was the Prince, there was the Priestess and the Prince for like 6 cost, 5 or 6 cost. 1 subtracted from 1, 1 subtracted from all of them. This is basically just a better version of that, which is good because nobody liked either of those cards, really. And yeah, you know, it's got Rush, which is, yeah, turn 6 Rush, it's decent. I'd play that in like a countdown deck, maybe. Although, really, I don't know, does it fit into like Haven, like Rush Haven? I don't actually think so, now that I think of it. Yeah, I don't know what deck you'd actually run this in. Maybe they're going to make, like, the shitty countdown amulets worth it in this expansion? I don't know. Wandering Bard, I think I heard of this one. Okay, yeah, I saw this one discussed a fair bit. Okay, so this... Okay, so you got to evolve him. Okay, and it's the evolve effect that people were freaking out about. So it basically nullifies, like, a bunch of abilities, but it costs you an evolution point. And frankly, it's not like you evolve him, and then it's not like you're going to trade him into anything either. So that's like, I don't actually know about this.
My heart in a verse.
He got shitty voice acting, too.
And a one, and a two.
God, that sounds really faggy.
Phew, what a nail biter.
Yeah, I think I'd keep this out of my deck just for that. But yeah, I don't know what deck wants to like get rid of all this. Like, does anyone really give that much of a shit about... I guess amulet fanfares as well. If it got rid of last words, I think it would be better, but... Oh well. Naval Guard Simone. Oh, it's got enhance. I like the enhance mechanic. It like lets you fill two of the cost slots in your deck at once in this one. So it's like 2-2 for two, vanilla. Or it can be, what is that, 5-5 ward for 5. Actually, 5... or, oh no, for 6. Okay, so yeah, it's not a strict improvement over, what was it, Enraged Etten or something? What is that, like a 5-4, 4-5 for 5 ward? So it's like kind of like that, except, you know, you've got the 2. I almost wish this were neutral. I don't know if you really want this in Swordcraft.
Dishonor the seas.
Oh, it's a woman. I wouldn't have guessed that.
These waters belong to us.
I bet you if I switch it to Japanese voice acting, that'll be a man. I almost guarantee you that when I make that switch over, this will turn out to be a man. Although I don't know, is that cleavage there? I thought it was just like, whatever. I guess I could look at the artwork. Or I think okay, Shrouded Assassin is like number one slot for artwork right now. That is it is animated, but still, that is a lovely ass, card. Anyways, we got the hippocampus, seriously. It's not even a hippo, it's a horse. Anyways. Oh, that is interesting. It's a dragon card. It has ward, and you evolve it and it loses ward. But it gains, like, a shit ton of stats. Or it gains, like, what? It gains 2 extra attack but loses ward. That's interesting. I actually like that a fair bit. Cool. Oh, yeah, and you got the radical transformation when you... Because, yeah, normally when you evolve, it just flips the artwork and adds some little bits and bobs to the... Basically recolors it a lot of the time and adds on some decals and stuff, but I like it when they transform it completely. This is pretty nice artwork, too. It's cool because, like, Dragoncraft, I feel like they want a lot of wards a lot of the time, especially, like, big mid-range ones. I run, what's his name? The 3-5, or no, the 3-7 ward for 5, the neutral one, Goblin Rider. This could be a decent replacement for that, I think. It's got a bit less health, but it's got that utility. You can take out some big stuff with the evolve. Lightning Blast, this is the one that people are freaking out about. Banish an enemy follower or amulet, which is just nuts right there. Banish an amulet, banish a follower, all sorts of just like late game stuff that gets rid of. Because yeah, that was kind of the problem with Dragoncraft, is like you go like heavy control and you still lose to not Alana's Prayer, the other one, in Statute Seraph, and you lose to Shadowcraft bullshit that you can't ever remove and have no counter to. Now you got a counter to that kind of stuff, so you can actually win. In fact, it's almost too much of a good thing, because you almost inevitably win late game now against those kinds of archetypes. And then, of course, you got the big Enhanced 10, where you banish all of them. And it's... Oh, I didn't even realize this. I thought it was like a... Everything. Like, clear the whole board, because that's what Dragoncraft removal usually is. But yeah, this is banish just the enemies, so it's like... Only the enemy side of the board on everything for 10, which is a lot, but still, that is really freaking powerful. I think I'd include one of these in like basically every Dragoncraft deck I ever make that isn't like face or something. So yeah, that's pretty powerful. Dragoncraft's been in, or at least the consensus is that Dragoncraft's been in bad shape for a long time. And we got the Wrathdrake. Another Dragoncraft card. Deal 1 damage to all other followers, or deal 3 instead for 8. 5 for 4, 4, so the stats are a little bit under the curve, but it 1 damage to everything. It might be decent as like a one of if you're worried about like fairy or snowman swarm or something like that, but other than that, not really amazing. I don't really like the enhance effect either, but it's playable. I'd say cool. We're like what, 10 minutes in, and that's pack number one. Pack number two of like 30 we're doing. Okay, this will get faster. Wrathdrake, we've seen. Shrouded Assassin, we've seen. Frogbat, I haven't seen this one. At the end of your turn, gain 1/0. That's a Bloodcraft card. 3 for 2/2, though. Oh, my. But it's at the end of your turn, so it's got regular stats at the end of the turn that you play it. So it's like kind of a shitty evolve for 3, but you don't evolve it. I don't know. In Bloodcraft, that seems a bit strange. That affects, because I don't think Bloodcraft really has anything to like defend it or anything. Are there even any wards you could put this behind in Bloodcraft? I think I would like this better in notion of the frog bat, but the effect, like, I don't know, maybe Swordcraft? Swordcraft's got enough good stuff, although I'm not really convinced this is good stuff either. Again, with the big radical transformation when you evolve it. Oh, what's this guy sound like?
Whatever shall I do?
I don't know.
Allow me to think. I take my leave.
I honestly don't know what I was expecting there. Hey, we got 2 frogs in this one. My god, this is the the pack of Keck. Okay, test of strength. I've heard this one mentioned, but I don't actually know what it does. Countdown 2, leaders cannot be attacked if there is a follower that can be attacked in their area. Okay, so this is both. So this kind of cuts both ways. It's neutral. This seems pretty powerful. Like, I get the feeling that this, or I don't know, it's 3. Like, you drop this on turn 3, that's a big tempo hit. It means that you're, and it also means that you're probably not going to have any followers. Like, yeah, the fact that you need followers to make use of this makes it questionable. Actually, it could be good in, like, Forestcraft or something, where you've got, like, a bunch of fairies on the board and they got to remove all of them to get at you. I don't know. I'd have to think about it. It could fit into a deck, but it's certainly... I was thinking, like, oh, it helps against aggro, but not really, because if you play this on turn 3, then you don't have any followers that they have to get through. Halo Golem. Earthrite, deal 3 damage to an enemy. That is pretty weak sauce. I don't think that even makes it into... Because, yeah, I run a Earthrite deck, and I don't think this even makes it into that. Or I don't know. The stats are actually all right, because Earth with an Earthrite deck, you've got a lot of wards. So with the 4, with the lower health, you have the big attack, but the lower health, but you can kind of hide behind your other wards. So that's decent, but still. Like, I don't want to consume my... Oh, an enemy! Never mind. I missed this up. Yeah, this is an enemy. You can attack people's faces with this. That's actually potentially super good. I wonder if, like, a Rush Earthrite archetype could arise from this. Okay, never mind. This is interesting. I like this. Vagabond Frog. Oh, Swordcraft Ambush. Already said that I like that. 3? What the fuck? How on earth is this worth 3 mana? I don't understand. Oh, right, and what did this guy sound like? Cool, I'm glad we took the time for that.
I go where the wind takes me.
Oh, did I evolve this guy too? Badass.
I'll find myself out on the road.
At the end of your turn, gain ambush. Like, if you combine this guy with the amulet for stealth, I guess he's super good. Because then, like, you hit something with him, then he just, like, he gets the +1/+1, you hit something with it, and then he gets ambush again, so he's, like, +1/+1 again. And I guess, yeah, you could use him to repeatedly attack face, and they can't remove him without, like, non-targeted removal. It's all right, potentially in the right deck, but 3 is a lot for... God, 2-1. It's overcosted by 2 for ambush, effectively. Effectively never-ending ambush, but still. Beetle Warrior, don't know what this is. Gain +1/+1 in Storm if 2 cards were played this turn. Okay, so it's like a shitty roach, kind of. Or I guess it's, I don't know, maybe a supplement to, like, roach stuff, although if you're playing... Like, if it's your roach turn, then I don't think this helps you at all. Do we get the, like, does this guy have a voice, or is he, like, skitter, 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 roach noises? Oh, wow. Sounds like a Zergling. Cool artwork, though. I bet you this one would be really badass in the animated form. Hopefully we'll get one of those. This is interesting. I'd maybe try it. In like, some kind of, like, fast, like, aggro... forest craft build. Impartial Strix. I think I saw this one spoiled, but I forget it. Neutral, get 2/2 if you have at least 20 neutral cards remaining in your deck. So not only do you have to have your deck constructed around this thing, but it's only good if you haven't drawn through half your deck already.
One must never take sides.
Huh, for some reason I was expecting like Hoot Hoot or something.
Balance!
Okay, yeah, something like that I was expecting.
Stay impartial.
Interesting.
Stay impartial.
I don't know if this is going to be too obscure a reference for you kids, but this here reminds me of the Grand, like just the glasses and the crown and everything, reminds me of the Grand Duke of Owls from Rockadoodle, if any of you guys grew up at the same time I did. Anyways, so that's pack number 2. Frogbat, we've seen, hey, we got our animated Beetle Warrior. Yeah, that is pretty cool. Got the flames rushing past, the glowing eyes. Yep, that's pretty badass. Okay, so we got that out of the way. That's pretty awesome. Gravekeeper Sonya, that's going to be a shadow card. What the fuck? Okay, never mind. So 3/5 ward. If there are no other allied followers in play, oh, that's a fanfare, so it gets... Okay, so yeah, in keeping with the... untargetable thing that Havencraft has a lot of.
Let them rest in peace. Leave. Rest with the others.
I don't think... I don't know. It's not exciting, I don't think. Chimera, I don't know what this is. I'm guessing neutral? Oh, Runecraft. Oh, God, more spell boost. Which type of spell boost? Fanfare deal 4 damage to an enemy follower. Okay, it's basically a Daria, like it costed like a Daria, except like way, way shittier, which I guess is fine for, you know, a silver rarity, but speaking of which, this is another really good pack in terms of just rarities that we've got here. 2 animated, too? Nice. I don't think I like this. This seems really shitty. Like, you get a lot of spell boosts for a kind... A lot of spell boosts for a kind of mediocre unit. Or I don't know, I guess you boost it 3 times and it becomes worth it. And frankly, if you're playing like a Daria, Daria deck, you're boosting it a lot more. Like, okay, if Daria pulls this, it costs 4 and... That's still a lot. Like, it's 4 for this unit is really good. Like, it's amazing value for 4. But, like, in the type of deck it fits into, I feel like it's too much. I don't know why you'd... I don't think this helps Runecraft at all, which is fine. They don't need the help, but I don't see this getting played. Vlad, Bloodcraft, at the end of your turn, deal 1 damage to all other followers if you evolve it. And it's a full evolve, which is nice.
That gaze! Such impudence!
Awesome. I think I'll run this guy just for
on
the voice
your
alone.
Hands and knees.
Yep, this guy's pretty cool.
These streams of blood!
Not super interesting, though. Or I guess, okay. Yeah, but deal damage to all other followers? That's a weird effect in Bloodcraft. I don't think it's actually very useful. And if you don't evolve it, it's just vanilla stat line. I guess it's like, you know, mass removal, which Bloodcraft already has way better. You just run... Or, okay, it's 5 cost mass... Or not really mass removal, but, you know, fairy removal, piddly follower removal. at 5 cost, which is 1 faster than they could get it otherwise. I still don't think it's very good. Dark Airjammer, Bloodcraft, put a random follower that costs 2 play points or less from your deck, repeat once. Okay, so it gets you one dude or 2 dudes. So it's basically an overpriced, or not overpriced, but it's the Goblin Mage in a bigger unit, and if you're Vengeance, then it's a double Goblin Mage, which is good because I believe there's some Vengeance synergistic stuff in this set. And hey, we got our full set of Beetle Warriors already, and 2/3 of the way to a full set of Air Jammers. I actually kind of, I don't know, we'll see if, I want this to be good. It's like a neat effect, and I'd like, if there's some way, easier ways to trigger Vengeance in this set, then I'll like that. Dragon's Nest. Oh yeah, I saw this one spoiled, and I thought it was just like the most insane shit. Like, at the start of your turn, restore 2 defense to your leader, draw a card, and destroy this amulet if overflow is active for you. Which sounds insane, depending on how you parse it. It's like, oh cool, I play this turn 1, and then I get 2 defense, draw a card, I get 2 defense and draw a card every turn until turn 7. And it's like, no, you only do those things once and then destroy the amulet. All of this happens only if overflow is active. Which makes it shitty. I don't know why you'd ever want to run this. Like, it's good. It's fine if you can play it turn 1, like for 1 mana, turn 1. And then, like, yeah, 5 to 7 turns later, you get 2 healing and a card. Fine. But, I mean, you're not going to put 3 of these in your deck for that reason. So yeah, it sucks. It just sucks. Windreader Zell. Oh, Argus. Yeah, that's not a follower, so we don't evolve it. Windreader Zell. Nah, I think this guy's name is Harry Potter. This guy will be Harry Potter every single time I look at him. Give an allied follower Storm if overflow is... Oh, shit. Oh, shit, son. That's potentially really good. That's potentially really, really good. And he's only 2, so you can, like, basically, if once you're at 10 mana, you can give an 8-cost dude Storm. And it's, yeah, Dragoncraft, so they got what? They got the 8-8 guy. Yeah, that's potentially really good.
The sky's my destination.
Yeah! That should be his voice clip that plays when he evolves. Whatever it's called, the 8-8 dude, I think.
Now, jump into the wind!
Oh, and I got him animated too, and he's got the lovely artwork that changes completely. Oh, this is a beautiful card. I love this one. What else we got? Dragon's Nest, Stolen Life. What is this? Haven't seen it before. 3 damage to an enemy, and then +3/+3 to a random ally. Okay. That seems pretty shitty. So deal 3 damage to an enemy follower. Normally that's like about a 2 mana effect. And then +3/+3. I don't think we've seen something like that before. +2/+2 is, I think, a 3 mana card. So it's like, I'd say like +3/+3 is like 4 mana, 4.5 kind of. So it's like you're getting what? I guess the cost is like about right. It's like maybe half a mana overcosted, but it's like, when is this like, oh, I've got 6 mana, you know what I want to do? I want to deal 3 damage to an enemy and give +3 to a random ally. It's like really situational when this is what you want to spend your 6 mana on. I don't see this getting played at all. Vlad again, fine. Sibel. Okay, so this is like a reverse wind god in Forest Craft, which is pretty cool. I don't really like the art style on this one. I don't know what it is. It's something seems off. It's like more, I don't know, I'm not an art critic.
The earth is my flesh. A bed of earth. The land
will this life. Actually could make your fairies like super annoying after a couple turns, and it's only 3. Oh, and it's got high HP as well, so it's not that easy to remove. Wow, this could actually potentially, like, if they don't remove this in Forest Craft, this could potentially get like out of control. I actually like this one quite a bit. I mean, I don't know if it's good, but it's like one of those cards. I could see this becoming a pet card, where even if it sucks, I try to build decks with it anyways. Little Soul Squatcher. I think, is this our first gold? I think this is like our first or second gold. Destroy an evolved enemy for 4. That's pretty situational.
My mouth's watering.
And it's...
Hey, why so angry?
Yeah, so it's vanilla, and it's... So the only thing you get from this is Necromancy 4, destroy an evolved enemy. That's pretty weak sauce.
Say bye-bye to your
This is a gold? Seriously, am I missing something here? This seems like it's not awful, but it's... Like, I would never run this over, like, any of the current 2-cost Shadowcraft cards. This... Yeah, this is not... And it's gold! Gosh. Yeah, this is not exciting. Caledonian... Or we saw this one, right. Don't worry, this will get faster and faster as we go through. Axe Fighter, I saw this guy spoiled, but I completely forget what he does. Neutral. Okay, so it's, like, just... Vanilla. So that's just a straight upgrade over the... Actually, is there a neutral 2-3? I know there's the 3-2, the Mercenary Drifter, but... Yeah, I guess this might be our first neutral 2-3 for all I remember.
Stay out of my axis.
Anyways,
reach.
This guy's got vanilla, or that. This guy's not vanilla. He's got enhanced 6 for 3-3, so he's... Or, okay, so for 6, that would get you, what, a 6-5? So it's basically a vanilla 3 drop or a vanilla 6 drop. The versatility is good. I'd actually easily run this in like a neutral based deck. Would I run it anywhere else? Probably not.
Nice and heavy. I'm gonna knock you out of this world.
Is it just me? His hair seems weird. It's like, I don't know. Reminds me of, I can't think of the name now. Whatever, we need to speed this along. Dead Moon Disciple, animated, lovely. Oh, this is one of those... I hate it when they have the bright lights on the animated cards. It just obscures the artwork. It's like you can't make out the detail as good when you've got, like, the really, like, bright lights flashing there. Give an allied follower the ability to ignore ward. Yeah, that was never really a... it's a one drop, though. Okay, yeah, it's a one drop. So, yeah, that fits very easily into Aggro Shadowcraft. My favorite deck... That was my... Oh, is that a legendary down there? I didn't even freaking notice. My goodness. Seems weird that there's no background music here. Should I put some music on? Nah, I won't bother. Ignore ward. Not an amazing effect, but, you know, it's a 1-1-1. Decent enough.
The moon and life both wane. I will shine on you.
Oh, did I turn the volume down somehow?
Pretty moon.
I can't hear that. I accidentally nudged my keyboard there for a second. Let's try a different one to see if that... Did I screw up my volume?
Drown
I screwed up my volume.
Venom. Come to me.
Okay, looks like I just nudged the knob. Okay. That'll be confusing for you guys, because it'll probably be sound normal to you, but I just nudged the volume knob on my headphones. Anyway, so yeah, that thing we were done with...
What will you look like dead?
Actually, this looks a lot better evolved, I think. She is, like, stick thin, I guess. Which is not really my style. But anyways, Candelabra of Prayers. Whenever you play an enemy, you let subtract 1 from its countdown. And that's just forever. So you just stick that out there. And then all your countdowns go down faster. Or actually, you put 2 of those out there. And then, like, your Phoenix, or your Falcons, and, like, your Storm guys are coming out as soon as you play them, which is potentially kind of insane. Although, I don't know, typically with those kind of aggro decks, you kind of want to flood the board a lot of the time, which means you don't really want your... And you also want, like, fat, like, really big tempo as well, so you don't really want your Candelabras sitting out there, taking up your turn 3 and taking up your board space as well, but I don't know. I'd try it. Dead Moon Disciple. Venomous Puce Worm. At the end of your turn, randomly discard one of the lowest cards in your hand and gain +2/+2. And it just... Okay, and that's at the end of your turn, so it just does that forever. Yeah, it's a slightly better effect than a lot of the discard Dragoncraft cards. I hope... That was the problem with the last set was that there was too much discard stuff in Dragoncraft, and most of it was pretty shitty. So as a result, Dragoncraft kind of got mostly shitty cards. This isn't as shitty as a lot of the ones we saw in the last set, but I really hope they don't go too hard on this whole discard dragon thing again.
All existence shall suffer.
Oh, hey, he speaks English. You never know with these dragoncraft dragons. It's like some of them speak English and some of them is just like, gow, gow, or whatever dragons say in Japanese. I guess they're speaking English now since I haven't switched the new set over yet. But yeah, that's interesting. It's a decent effect, better than most effects you see in discard dragon. I don't play a lot of discard dragon, but I'm sure there's something shitty in that deck that you could replace with this. Hippocampus, we saw this. Blood Moon, I think this is the one. Yeah, Vengeance is active, so for the next 4 turns you get Vengeance, even if your leader's defense is more than 10. Bloodcraft has other deck archetypes that don't revolve around Vengeance, but like, oh, there's like so many cards in Bloodcraft that are just dead because Vengeance is so hard to trigger and so easy to play around for a lot of decks that just like burst you down from 20 these days. So yeah, this enables like a whole lot of stuff in Bloodcraft that was just unplayable before. So yeah, Vengeance decks could become a thing now. As soon as I saw this, I was really excited for it. This could be good if I get two more of them out of my pack. And then, okay, my legendary, Deepwood Anomaly. I'm guessing forest craft. Whenever this follower attacks the enemy leader, deal damage to... Okay. Okay. I didn't see this one spoiled. So if you hit them, they die and you win. And it's 8 for an 8/8. Which means if this were a Dragoncraft card, you could just give it Storm and just make it a one-hit KO combo. Oh my god, this is crazy. I really like this. I don't even know if it's good, but it's funny. Yep, that sounds about right. That's I think that's the noise I'd make if I saw this played against me. Just I don't know what deck this fits into, really. I guess this is like a new win condition or something. Yeah, you just hit their leader and you win for 8. Nice, solid. I love it. Another lightning blast. Awesome. I was definitely newing. I knew I wanted at least 2 of those. Grave Desecration. That's got to be Shadow at the end of your turn. At the end of your opponent's turn. Oh, that's potentially good. So at the end of their turn, so you get to it. So it's effectively a zombie with Storm, more or less. Because yeah, at the end of the opponent's turn means that it's there at the start of your turn, so you can attack with it. So effectively, it's like a mini. What's the one that gives the 9-cost dragon amulet that gives you wind blast dragons? This is basically that, except not really even a mini version of that, like a micro version of that. It's instead of 9-cost 5/5s with storm, it's 2-cost 2/2s with storm, and it costs you necromancy 4. I mean, yeah, that's basically a free mummy every time you have 4 shadows. You could build a deck around this, I think, actually, if I've got that right, where you get to attack with the zombie. Oh, and actually, I saw the Shadowcraft legendary, one of the Shadowcraft. Was it a legendary or an amulet? Maybe both. We'll see if we get it, but I know there's a card that goes with this that could make it potentially really good. Oh, literally useless, I think, if you have 2 of them, though. I don't think you get any benefit. Or I guess if you have 2 of them, then you get 2 zombies for 8. And then if you get 3, there's literally no benefit, but whatever. Vist the Elf Butler. I guess it's like he's an elf, but on the other hand, he's a butler. So I don't know if he's forest or sword, but okay, he's forest. So 2/5 ward. Whenever you play a forest craft follower that costs at least 6 play points, subtract 3 from cost of this card. And it's whenever you do it. So this is basically a free ward. A free 2/5. Except... okay, so he's like kind of... is he overcosted? So he's what, a 2/5 ward for 4. That's about right, maybe? But then it gets, like, way cheap if you wait and play them later on. So if you're going, like, Super Control Forest, which... I think Bolt, Silver Bolt Forest tends to go pretty late. They don't usually get to play their Silver Bolt right on turn 9. Yeah, this could be good. Oh, it's followers only, which makes it a little bit worse, but... What's he sound like?
My sword and spells can handle this.
Oh, I think this is the faggiest one we've heard yet.
My sword and spells can handle this. May I ask your name? Forgive the intrusion.
Wow, I think this guy has set a new standard for faggotry in Shadowverse. You know, which is fine. That's not a pejorative thing. It's just descriptive, guys. I have nothing. Hell, I even find it a little bit charming. It's just purely descriptive, I'm saying here. Pure healer. Good. Haven, yeah, Elana did not have enough healing effects. Yeah, now she's got a 4-cost heal as well. Why not? Fill in every frickin' slot with a heal. I guess Elana's not that strong right now anyways. It's just kind of annoying to play against sometimes when you play it. And it's like, oh, okay, so she's got Elana's prayer and she's going to heal on turn 4 and turn 5 and turn 6. And you just can't kill her. The enhance effect is kind of shit, though. And it's a little bit, is it overcosted? It kind of is, because all of the other healing cards are like, they got like vanilla stats with the healing on top of it. This one, it's got a little bit less, it's got like one less stat point, and the enhance effect is not very good at all. But, you know, whatever.
Let me care for your body.
That's an interesting way of phrasing that.
You mustn't.
It's almost like a little narrative they're telling there.
But without me, you'll...
It's like she says...
Care for your body.
She says that, and then someone gets the wrong idea, and then...
You mustn't.
I don't know. You know how your mind gets when you look at this... when you're looking at this Shadowverse artwork all day, every day.
I'm here at your side.
And, yep, she basically just takes her clothes off when she's... Or at least, what, takes the corset off when you evolve her. Typical Shadowverse. And we got the Aqua Nereid. Summon a Megalorca. You know, I always kind of wanted the Megalorca thing. I think what... There's the one dragon card that evolves your Megalorcas, and I think there's the other one... I forget. I think there's another one that... Or maybe it just summons a Megalorca. I always wanted the Megalorca thing to be a thing.
Cute little orca.
And then Megalorca was a 2-2, I believe. Yeah. Okay, so it's just basically... Actually, yeah, that's 3-3 worth of stats distributed across 2 units. That's actually potentially really good. I don't know if it's good in Dragon. If this were a sword card, it would be insane, but... Actually, I think there is a sword card that basically does this now that I think of it. But, yeah, lovely artwork, too. Yeah, look at the eyes seem a bit weird to me on the evolved one. The normal one's fine. Normal one has lovely eyes, but yeah, cool. Love that one. Phoenix Rider. Okay, we got another gold here. Phoenix Rider Aina. Oh wow, it's a 1/5 storm, but gains 1 for each other follower in play. So at best. Dragoncraft doesn't really tend to flood the board a lot, and even if they do, that's like... Or okay, 5/5 for 6, that's a really shitty forte, actually. And it's a fanfare effect. So, yeah, this is... incredibly shitty.
Ha! Yeah. Easy pickings! These flames will flare again! Ha! You challenge me?
That's a long voice clip.
Ha! These... Ha! Burn the skies.
Oh, okay, I get it. I was missing it. Each other follower. It's not just your own followers. So if the enemies flooded the board, say with like fairies or some shit, then you get... Yeah, say they got a board full of like 4 fairies, then you get... Yeah, you'll get your full 5/5. And then if you've got some stuff on top of that, okay, this could get really big. It's situational, and you would like never ever run this over forte. But, you know, it's just more face dragon, basically. Just like face dragon's got more face, which I feel they kind of needed anyways. I don't know if they needed more 6-cost face. I feel if this were like, I don't know. It'll get run, probably. Maybe. Like one or two copies. Iron Maiden. No idea what this is. Haven. Could have guessed that. Countdown 2. At the end of your turn, deal 2 damage to a random enemy follower, and it can't attack next turn. So the damage is kind of like who gives a shit, but the can't attack is potentially super strong, and that's going to happen twice, and it's going to happen at the end of the turn that you play it. So, okay, it's just basically just to draw out the game, essentially. Typical Haven card. Well, I don't really know how strong it is, but I bet you this will get experimented with a fair bit. It could end up being, like, super good. I imagine this, yeah, will help stall a lot for, like, so bad, I shouldn't even, I'm just bad at coming up the statue, Enstatued Seraph, that's the one. I'm so bad at coming up, remembering card names. Okay, almost halfway through the first bit. Baphomet. Put a random Bloodcraft follower with at least 5 attack from your deck into your hand. And then, okay. And then subtract 3 from its cost. So you're spending 3 extra to subtract 3 from its cost. I don't know what the point of that is. Whatever. And it's, what, 2-1? Okay, so it's kind of... This could be decent for control, I guess, where it's like you're kind of setting up for the late game. Like, yeah, I don't think aggro blood has anything with more than 5 attack. But yeah, this... Actually, what... Actually, I don't think any... Or okay, this would be like, what, your queen vampires? It wouldn't be Alucard. Or is it... No, is it queen vampire? The 9-cost one that deals... That drains 5 damage from something. Yeah, it lets you tutor those guys, and that's decent. Okay. And then you subtract 3 from its cost. That's a sick combo, actually. Soul Surf for 5. Yeah, you get to play that on turn 6. That's actually crazy, potentially. Okay, I can see that. Judge of Retribution. That's... Oh, I was going to guess Runecraft on that. Oh, and what's this guy?
Awaken.
Oh, nice. It seems like there's a lot more cards with, like, the full... transformation, where it's like they don't just reverse and palette swap it. A lot of these cards, they change the artwork quite a bit for the evolves. Love that. It's a good looking card too.
Tremble in fear.
Okay, Judge of Retribution. Fanfare. Banish a card. Banish a follower with 3 defense or less, then draw a card. Oh, it's 6 though. Okay. It's banished though, so that'll take care of your Mordecai, and it's draw a card.
All right.
This is just like a bunch of different stuff. It's a 3/5. It's a banish 3 or less. It's a draw a card.
Guilty. Impenitent sinners. Impenitent sinners.
Yeah, it's probably pretty good. I like it. I don't actually have any cards for, like, late game Haven. Like, I don't have Alana's Prayer, I don't have Enstatued Seraph. I don't even have Themis's Decree. I have, like, one of those, so I can't really run late. I don't really know anything about, like, the control Haven decks. Gravekeepers. Oh yeah, we saw that one, Tristan. I think I heard about this one. If an allied commander is in play, gain last words, summon a Tristan. This seems pretty shitty. It's what? Overcosted by 1. And if a commander's... Okay, so it's a fanfare. No, if it's a if fanfare, gain last words. So the last word triggers and summons another one, but the next one you get won't trigger the fanfare no matter what. So even if you have a commander in play, the one that gets summoned by last words... actually, you know what? This could be good now that I think of it. If you have the commander in play, this is actually really good. Because you, you get 2 3/4s for 5, which is insane.
I must not perish.
Very manly voice, too. I like that. Setting a new standard.
How?
New standard for manliness in Swordcraft. I guess that's not true. There's a bunch of manly cards that don't get played. Yeah, I'm including Albert in that evaluation, by the way. Stupid little pretty boy looking, whatever. Dryad, I think I saw this one spoiled. I like this one. It's not amazing, but, you know, it's fine. It can trade her. Or I guess it doesn't really trade efficiency with other. It basically brings other two. It brings other like two cost units down to its level. So like you attack a 2/2 with it, and then you're both at 1/1. So it's like, or yeah, it's kind of neat. I don't know if it gets played, but
why did you come here? You can't. It hurts.
Kind of cute too. Oh, she turns into like almost like a. It's like she's all green, and then she's like a little less green. It's like she's like turning human or something, even though she's got like more vines and shit. Or actually, no, I guess she's got fewer vines. Just they're just thicker vines. Whatever. Oh, hey, another one of these guys. I think this is my favorite card of the pack so far, or favorite of the set. Elf Queen, another legendary. No, wait, isn't Elf Queen? Oh no, I'm thinking Vampire Queen. Yeah. Elf Queen, restore X defense to your leader, where X is the number. Oh, this is Forest Craft. Right, what was I thinking? Yeah, I was thinking this was Bloodcraft for some reason. Oh yeah, I was confusing it with the Vampire Queen. She looks kind of like the Vampire Queen, doesn't she? And I know I'm confusing it, because there's the 6-cost one that gives your bats ward, and then there's the 9-cost one that drains 5. I think one of them is Vampire Temptress, maybe? I don't know. They're both Vampire Queen to me, so whatever. Okay, so X is the number of shadows you have, then change your shadows to 0. So this is like not Purgatory Forest, for sure. But if you're not Purgatory Forest, you can just like... It's like, what's it called? The lion, the Forest Craft Lion that regenerates your health. This is another Forest Craft card that generates a lot of health. Like you don't need a lot of shadows to get like tons of health. Like what, and like at, yeah, at seven, by turn 7, yeah, you easily have like 7 or 8 shadows probably. So yeah, this is really big. And it's like decently statted too. 6/6 for 7, solid.
Your names will live on.
What accent is that?
Elfin Blade. Soon we'll be reunited. Woodkin. Prey on my sword.
it's like if somebody tried to fan dub like Fran from Final Fantasy 12. What the hell?
Your names will live on.
Whatever. Seen it. Luminous Mage, summon a Luminous Knight. Is that a card that exists already? Oh right, that's the Swordcraft card. Yeah, 2/1. And you can evolve it to give all other allied followers +1 until the end of the turn. I feel like that would be way better if it were all followers. I always thought it should have been all followers so that it could get like the full, at least like the full attack for the evolve, but whatever. It's, yeah, I never played Luminous Knight because I never thought. Anyways, oh, and evolution points won't be used when you evolve out for 5. Okay, so like just stat-wise, it's, what, 4/4, just in the stats it gives you in units, a 2/3 and a 2/1. I believe the math on that comes out to 4/4. And then is Luminous Knight, yeah, Luminous Knight is a commander, so you get to evolve it for free. And then it gives this one plus attack, but you can't attack with it anyways. This seems actually insane. So you get 4/4 worth of units, except for free, or really you get a 2/3, and you get a 3/2 and +1 to all your other units, and rush on the 3/2, and you get to evolve all future commanders for free. This is actually insane. How is this not like gold or legendary? Okay, it's 5 costs, so I guess it's sharing a slot with Albert, even though Albert's more of a 9 cost. But yeah, that's kind of crazy. God. I really didn't want Swordcraft to get more good stuff in this set. I'm afraid of what this forebodes for the next month of laddering. Holy shit. Mighty Dwarf, I haven't seen this. Forestcraft, deal 2 damage to the... Okay, so Clash, deal 2 damage to the enemy leader. Why would you want to do that? On turn 7, you start clashing to deal... Okay, I guess do a little bit of chip damage to set up for your roach combo on turn 8 or something.
The beards my pride and joy.
Oh, did I evolve this?
Turn the power of hope to light.
Yep, and like Like most Shadowverse cards, takes off. Wow, she strips right down when you evolve her. Right down. Wow. Okay, and Mighty Dwarf.
The beard's my pride and joy. I'll chop it right off.
This just seems like a boring card, and I don't know why you'd want to run this. Like, you don't... you don't run this in aggro. You don't... And for 7 cost, it doesn't synergize with, like the forest idea of, like, playing multiple cards per turn. Like, you're not going to trigger a if-you-played-2-cards thing off this Mighty Dwarf thing. Yeah, that seems kind of shitty. I don't think that'll see play. Prince Catacomb. Not Prince of the Catacomb, but Prince Catacomb. That is his name. Give all eyed followers last words, summon a skeleton. Now, I don't think I've seen... Like, I'm assuming that if an ally... Like, if you have a last words effect already, this will just add it rather than overwrite it. So, you'll be, like, last words, summon the lich and the skeleton for the guys that summon the liches, for example. I'm guessing that's how that works. Otherwise, this is terrible. As is, and you don't really want to play it on turn 3 because you want, like, a lot of board presence. I was going to say you could do it with the Phantom Rush, but the ghosts banish themselves. Or, okay, if you wanted to do, like, a stupid combo, you could put, the two drop that makes your banished guys, makes your guys get destroyed when they're banished, and then this guy, or no, and then Phantom Rush, and then this guy, and then your ghosts will spawn skeletons. Yeah, that's a game-winning combo right there. I don't think this is very good, however, I've got to say.
Dance, dear Bones of White. Dance, dear Bones of White. What are you hiding inside?
Absolutely fabulous. See, that's the thing. There's a fine line between faggotry and fabulosity, and this guy is, like, way off on the fabulous side. I love it.
Too amusing.
Indeed. Okay. Gravekeeper, Merman, Dolor Blade Warrior. Wow, we're going to be here for hours. Fanfare, destroy an allied follower and give this follower +2/+2. That's got to be a Shadowcraft. Doesn't activate if there's no others in play. So it's basically vanilla. So a vanilla 5 drop, but with this effect where it can get bigger if you destroy a follower. We're basically you've got to destroy, like, a ghost or a skeleton or something to like come out ahead stats wise.
I'll pick you to the bone.
I was not expecting that voice out of that dude.
Show me your soul up close. Ah! Still need more. I'll pick you to
I was
the bone.
Yeah, I was not expecting that at all. That's a new standard for something. I think that's a whole new archetype that, like, doesn't even fit into any of the voices I've heard in this game before. I don't know. It's not amazing. It's like basically you can convert a skeleton into extra stats for this guy. And, you know, on turn 5, that's decent. Like, yeah, get for 5 mana, getting a 6/7 and then evolving it to get like an 8/9 could be really good. Although by turn 5, they can just remove it anyways. I don't know. I don't think you can use this to trigger last words effect as well. So you can, like, destroy your whatever has last words as well. So, okay. Yeah. Fuck skeletons. Yeah. You destroy, like, your lich makers and your destroying enemies. Again, I should just do that where I don't even bother trying to remember the name of the card. Clash, destroy the enemy follower if its attack is 1. That is, I was expecting Forest Craft out of this. That is some artwork. I've seen this artwork before and I thought it was a joke. Like, I thought this was just like some meme that I wasn't aware of and someone had made a fake card. And it was just, like, spreading across the Shadowverse Reddit. This is an actual thing that they put into the game. The effect is good, though. I actually rather like this. Like, the price is right. Like, 2 for 2/1. It's, like, it's mainly the attack that you want out of the... and it's a clash, too. So if they attack you, then so it's, yeah, like it can't get, like the problem with two ones is that it, you know, they get killed by things with one attack. But oh god, and yeah, this kills shit like what's his name? Bloodcraft guy that damages you every time you play something. Urius. Yeah, this is actually really good, maybe. It depends, but yeah, I think it's decent. Spiderweb, Imp, Bloodcraft, Ward, deal 2 damage, blah? Okay, it's 1-4, so it's basically, yeah, it's one of those things where you get extra stats, but damage your leader if Vengeance isn't active. Pretty standard. Oh, what noises does this fucking thing make?
I'm hungry!
Yeah.
Hunger's killing me.
Yeah, that's about what I would have expected. What about this? So yeah, this
is my home. Should I
This is a pretty boring card. Right, we'll just move on from that. okay, and the last one of the set. Halo, Test of Strength, Hippocampus, Dazzling Healer. Oh, I was gonna say that's gotta be Haven. Followers. Okay, so it doesn't reduce this cost, it just restores more health to your followers, because Runecraft wants to heal their followers all the time.
Those boo-boos look bad. Cranky, cranky.
And she sounds like that to boot.
A kiss will make it all better.
You know, she actually gets kind of, like, super cute when you evolve her. It's, I don't know, something with her face, it's maybe the lighting. Maybe she just... I think it's just that she looks better in red. The hair is different, too. The hell is that in the background? Anyways, this card is garbage. I don't think anyone's ever going to play this unless I'm missing something. Yeah, heal your followers in Runecraft. Why? 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 Goblin Zombie. At the end of your turn, Necromancy 4 to gain 2/2. Okay, so this is like that... The Shadowcraft version of that Dragoncraft card that discards your shit for 2/2. So if you have Necromancy 4 already, this is just a 4/5 for 3, essentially. I feel like 2/2 for Necromancy 4 is like a good bargain. I think this is a pretty decent card, I think.
My nose fell off. You really
what are you talking
stink.
About? It's right there. Okay, now his nose... Wait, what? No, now his nose has fallen off. Like, see, this one, like, kind of has a nose. And this one, like, doesn't even have a face at all. Again, probably the most radical transformation from the Evolve I think we've seen so far. But yeah, that's, decent. Zombie Party, 3 damage to an enemy follower, and then summon 3 zombies. Okay, so it's your standard 2-for-3 nuke, and then you can summon 3 zombies for 5, so it's like a mini, again, the card names, the six cost spell that summons the zombies with the ward. only you're effectively spending 5 for it, or 5 extra for it, and no shadows, which is good. More bowmen. Whenever your leader's defense is destroyed. Oh, God. Oh, no. What are you doing? No, this can't happen. And he's a 2-drop. Holy shit. I wonder, could you kill combo? No, that for 2 damage. Yeah, 2 damage on every heal. No, you can't really wombo combo someone with this. Although this is... Like, often Alana's decks are kind of lacking... Like, they're just kind of hoping to overwhelm you and, like, get a massive board... Outlast you, basically. Get a massive board presence and just basically keep getting a massive board presence until you don't have any removal left. So I guess this is, like, kind of an alternate way to win the game off of that, although... And I guess, yeah, if you've got this in Alana's and you're healing anyways, eventually this guy buff... Like, in fact, yeah, you could buff this guy up right away. If you put him down in the late game, get 2 heals on top of it, you've got... 4 damage to the enemy leader, and all of a sudden he's a 4/4 on top of it. So, yeah, that's solid. That'll see play, I think, in one Haven archetype. And we got 2 legendaries out of the 10. That is better than average. We're going to have to speed through these ones a little bit. Okay, come on, come on, come on. Give me something good. Maybe we'll just do the first 10, because this is taking a while. Or maybe we'll do the full thing. I don't know. Wandering Bard.
My heart in a verse.
Right, I remember that guy. Oh, this guy's new. Earthshock Ogre. Neutral. Fanfare deal 3 damage. Okay. I feel like this would be like a million times better as like an enhanced thing. Or where it's like that other one where it's like, if this were like a 2 to deal 3 damage to an enemy, enhance 8, summon this thing as well. Or if this were like a 6 cost 6/6, enhance 8, deal 3 damage to an enemy as well. Other than that, though, I mean, it's... eh. Like, for 8 mana, you expect something, like, really fucking good. Like, something that, like, for example, something that'll win the game if it hits the enemy leader. Or, okay, speaking of which, this can hit the enemy leader, which is decent. Although, I feel like if you're running a neutral deck, I like Gilgamesh a lot better in the 8 cost slot. A lot better, especially with Sahakwiel these days. Yeah, and Sahakwiel won't trigger the fanfare either, so yeah. And if you're running a neutral deck, you're running Sahakwiel, so yeah. I don't see this getting played over Gilgamesh. Or I don't know, maybe some kind of... this is like the second one where I've been like, oh, you can damage the enemy leader, so maybe just like pinging the enemy leader to death will become a thing from now on. Seems like there's a lot of effects you can use to just ping for 2 or 3 these days. Seen that one. Did we see this one? Okay, we've seen it now. Pretty... Okay, so it's like that, what, Maiju, something like that. The Haven guy that has resistance to, that has targeting resistance. This one gives targeting resistance to something else, which is potentially, like, way better. You can give the resistance to something, like, really good, but if there's nothing on the board, then there's no extra benefit.
Let the mist wrap around you. Now then.
That looks like a woman. He's got an earring as well.
The mist and you shall be one.
Okay, you can. I guess you can see the earring here as well. It's not quite as pronounced. Actually, this looks really feminine now that I'm looking at it. Just like the face and everything. I would not be surprised at all if this had like a woman's voice in the Japanese voice pack. I don't think I evolved this. Okay. Not a dramatic change, but pretty cool looking. Okay, and that's that. We're gonna rip through this. Okay, we're gonna go through twice as many packs in half the time. I'm gonna try to keep this video under half an hour. Or under half an hour. Under an hour and a half. This is exciting. There's some... I don't know, there's a mix of, like, good, bad, and mediocre stuff in here, I'd say. I don't know, maybe we could skip at this point. Although, I don't know, it's been, like I said, I'm kind of superstitious about this. I swear to God, I've been getting way more legendaries ever since I stopped hitting the skip button. It's been, like, actually insane. And it's been proven out in the last set, too. We got 2 legendaries out of the last, what, 11 packs. Anyway, zombie party, got another one of these. Dragon Slayer's price. Discard your hand and deal damage. Wow, that's really bad. Why would you do this? Or, okay, I guess the amulet that lets you draw cards for everything you discard is like 3 cost. So I guess if you've got that in play, it's fine. Also, it's 4 mana removal, so that's fine. Like, you'd think for discarding your hand, you'd think it would at least be damage the enemy followers. But no, clear your own fucking board too. But I don't know, 4... mana removal is good, but you absolutely need that other stupid amulet in play to make use of it. Beetle Warrior, Test of Strength, Spring Cleaning. I saw this spoiled as well. I don't understand the point. So for 3 turns, discard the highest cost card in your hand and draw a card. So you can get rid of your Alberts. And all of your Alberts and your, again, other card names of cards that are expensive, and replace them with more spring cleaning, I guess. Another shitty one drops that you don't want. Yeah, this is really bad. I can't even think. Yeah, let's get rid of the clutter. Yeah, I don't know what they were thinking. It's cute. I like the artwork. But, yeah, nobody will ever play this. There's literally no benefit. This actually hurts you. This is like an anti-card. Hey, that's like, what, our fourth lightning blast now? Awesome. Stolen life, dryad. Assault werewolf. Gain bane if the enemy follower has ward. Okay, so you can kill wards, but nothing else. And it's... I think 2-5 is normal stats for 4. Yeah, because 3-4 would be normal, so 2-5 is fine as well. Oh, and Bloodcraft? I don't know about... Oh, okay. Yeah. I wish... I don't know. I don't see this getting played much. Like, 4 mana, and it doesn't have rush or anything, so you'll have to, like, evolve it to remove the ward that's in the way, and it doesn't really help you unless the ward is bigger than 4. So, yeah. I don't think it's very good. Mage of the Nightfall. Earthrite gain 1-1 and ambush. Okay. So there's another one, another Earthrite for 3. Or another 3 drop. Yeah, follower. It's what gains +1/+1 and ward, I think. Might have even been 2-2 and ward, but I think it was 1-1 and ward. I think that one's like just strictly better than this. Like, I don't know. I think that Dirt Runecraft likes... I just saw that pulsating thing there. What a time to be alive. I'm so glad I have this in my collection now. Ribbit. Ribbit. Anyways, I said we were going to speed up. Yeah, I don't think Ambush is as good as Ward in Dirt Room. We'll see if I'm wrong, but yeah, that's that. That guy again, I swear I've got like 4 of these already. Certainly got like 4 of these. That's amazing. That's like the most animation I think I've ever seen in any of these cards. And I got it on the big one as well. Wow. I feel like I need to put this card in more decks just for that reason alone. Luminous Standard. I don't even know what this was. Whenever a commander comes into play, give it 1-1. And it's 3 mana to play. So your Albert will hit for an extra damage. Is that even viable? Have like an all-commander Swordcraft deck? I don't think that can work. I don't think this card can work. Like, what's even the benefit? So it's like what really benefits from... Or okay, there's the other guy. Is he even a commander? I think he's a commander. The guy that damages the enemy follower for his attack every time he attacks. Or every time he... No, what? I think it's like clash deal his attack damage to the enemy leader or something. Or maybe it's not even his attack damage. Maybe it was a solid number that just increases when you evolve him. I don't have that card, so I don't know how it works. Enchanted Sword. Kick-ass artwork. That's a lovely looking one. And Rune, give an allied follower 2-2 for 7. Subtract. Oh, this is actually potentially really good. Because you can stick it on your Spellblade, whatchamacallums. The storm guys. So you can have like 3 storm guys in your hand for 0 and have 3 of these guys in your hand for 0 and then just, yeah, attack the enemy leader for what, 12, 14 damage all in one turn for 0 mana. Excellent. So yeah, that's a Daria card for sure. Or hell, even regular rune or regular Runecraft, what's it called? Dimension Shift. Because sometimes with D-Shift, you have a hard time getting enough threat in your hand to one turn KO them, and this will help you with that. Although until then, it just kind of sits in your hand. It's certainly meant for Daria, though. X, right, that guy. Oh, Man-Eating Mangrove. Whenever an enemy follower attacks your leader, deal 2 damage to that leader. To that follower. Interesting. And it's countdown 2. Okay. That is... Okay, now that... Yeah, I was saying how that, what, test of strength... I was thinking, like, almost sorta kinda could be anti-aggro, except not this. This is anti-aggro. So it's like every time they attack your leader, they die. Like, yeah, alright, I don't want turn three, they won't really die. Or, I mean, yeah, they will, because if they've been flooding the board on turn one and two, and you haven't been keeping it under control, turn three, you drop this, and then they... Or, okay, so it's when they attack, so I... Now, this... I could be mistaken. If I'm reading this wrong, then it's not as good, but I believe that when they attack, triggers before the damage hits you. So these guys will... So any, if it'll be like they'll die... Like, if they have less than 2 HP, they will die before the damage gets in on you. Which so basically anything with less than 2 health won't be able to attack you without getting killed, if I'm reading that right. I believe that when that like whenever they attack, triggers before the attack happens. So yeah, that's a good one. I like that. Wish I could have seen more of those so far. I guess we'll see if we get them. Halo Golem. Oh, we got a new gold. Soothing Harpist. Oh, I was going to guess Forest Craft on that, but it's a neutral. Fully restore defense of an allied follower that has attacked this turn and give it the ability to attack one more time. Okay, that's pretty good. So, I'm going to be here for a long time if I go over the possibilities of this, but this is pretty solid. She looks exactly the same. Or okay, she's a little bit... A little bit more golden evolved, I guess. And the flowers are a few more of them and a bit more green, but that is pretty lazy on the evolve artwork there, I gotta say. Anyways.
Listen to the melody. Open your ears. A sound for all the world.
Yeah, that's insane. I'm gonna have to, like, contemplate that one overnight or something, because damn, that might be the most interesting effect. Or certainly the most potentially powerful effect we've seen so far. Double cut. Okay, so God, I've been getting a lot of the same cards. Or I guess these sets aren't that huge. Yep, these are all repeats. I knew this would go faster. Oh, is that the first animated one of these we've seen? I feel like it isn't. Got another Candelabra. That'll be fine to like try a couple of these in a deck, I think. Yep, we've seen all these. No legendaries yet. Looks like my... Or from this, like, set of 10, at least. Maybe my luck's drying up. Fairy Cage. I saw this spoiled back in the day. This is one of the first ones they released. I forget what it does. Whenever you play a card, put a fairy in your hand if you don't have one. So basically, you can, like, flood the board with fairy. Oh. Oh, yeah. So you get a fairy in your hand, and you play it. And then you get another fairy in your hand. You can just literally just flood the board with fairies every single turn. For 4 mana, though, that's a lot. That's a lot, a lot. Still, you would basically guarantee that you always get to trigger your play at least 2 cards effects. That seems potentially really powerful. I think we need to see some better effects of that nature, though. Also, beyond some points, your board will be full of fairies as well, which is often a problem with Forest Craft. Mage of the Nightfall. Right, that was the shitty ambush thing. Oh, hey, Animated Healer. Pretty nice. Ooh, Magic Illusionist. I think that's new. Last words. Earthrite, summon a Magic Illusionist. That's dumb. This card is dumb.
Come gather round. Impressed yet? You figured it out. Figure out my tricks yet?
Okay, I was expecting more from the voice there, just from the artwork. I felt like, I don't know, I felt like we were in for something, but...
Come gather round.
Eh, it's alright. So, yeah, it just summons itself. I don't know if summoning a 2-2 for, like, Earthrite summon a 2-2 is not amazing. I feel like there's better things I could be spending my Earth runes on. I don't know, maybe I'll try it. Although I feel like this isn't what Dirt Rune needs right now. Tristan, Owlcat, Frogbat, Lightning Blast, Dragon Scyther. Bane and Storm if Overflow is active. 3 for a 2-2 Bane, and it gets Storm if Overflow is active. So it's basically just removal. Just removal for 3. if overflow is active, which it probably, I don't think. Oh, and actually, you know what? It's storm too. Yeah, it's not rush, it's storm. So you can actually just attack face with this as well if you want to. Yeah, it's removal and it's attack face. And it's only 3. It doesn't cost any extra. So yeah, that's just solid. Yeah. Very, very, very playable.
Ha! You sloth! You're finished! Could've done worse.
Cute too.
Cowards! Weaklings!
Especially the evolved form. Love the little fang there. The hell is going on with this dragon? Or I guess it's wearing a helmet or something?
Cowards! Weaklings!
Yeah, the dragon helmet is a bit stupid, but the girl is cute. I like it. So a bit of a shortage on the sexy ladies, I've got to say, in this set. I'm a bit disappointed, if I'm honest. I was looking at through the artwork for some of Grand Blue Fantasy cards and the Rage of Bahamut and all that. I was hoping they'd bring Hecate into this set, but I don't think they're going to. 3 damage to an enemy follower for 3, then 2 damage to the enemy leader if at least 2 cards were played in Forest. Okay, that's... 3 damage for 3. I don't think it's going to get played. Tarnished Grail, Haven, countdown 3. 2 damage to all followers when you play it. And you get... okay. And you get 3 apocalypse cards. Yeah, that's the apocalypse deck right there. You can get an Astaroth's Reckoning. Okay, so this is basically just like a mini Seraph, essentially. Or I mean, okay, it's not as good as Seraph, but yeah, you can basically just, like, yeah, put more Seraphs in your deck, essentially. I mean, okay, you hope to get the Astaroth's Reckoning, and... I mean, yeah, Astaroth's Reckoning followed by Dis's Damnation or the Silent Rider, and they're just fucked. Although that's, like, what, 3 to tick down the amulet and then 2 to play the cards, so that's... It's not as reliable as Seraph, but... I like it. Like, I said, I don't own Seraph, so I can actually kind of run those decks now. Using Grail as a substitute. Yeah, that's basically what it is. It's just budget Seraph. I like it. And it's like a fun... I wish that this had been like what they did. Like, I wish that instead of in Statute Seraph, we got this instead in the first place. Because this is just more fun, I think. It's a better effect. Maybe could stand to be a bit stronger. Maybe. Like, comparing it to Seraph. Maybe if you got like 4... Oh, and it says 3 of the following 4, so I believe that means you get 3 different ones, if I'm parsing the grammar of that correctly. Maybe I'm not, but it's actually, I think it's a lot better if it is 3 different ones from those. Yeah, that is a cool one. I like that a lot. Goblin Princess I saw spoiled. Don't like the artwork. What's with those black lines? And the face is like... lumpy. Or okay, I guess, you know, she's a goblin, so she's not supposed to be that cute, I guess, but gets 2 goblins and a goblin king in your hand. So the goblins are 2/1, so that's like what, 2, 2, 5. So that's like what, 4, 5 worth of stats? Which is, yeah, so basically vanilla stats spread across 3 units, which is decent. It's neutral. Oh, actually, that goes really good with that's actually insane with the Valkyrie Spear. Because then you get like what? You get like 7/5 worth of stats spread across 3 units with that. That's actually, like, I think neutral, like null craft might actually become a thing now. And then you get the Goblin King, which is not a card yet. What is Goblin King? 4 for a 5/5 ward, which is, yeah, that's that's a good card. That's like what? Undercosted by probably. 1, or yeah, undercosted by 1, essentially. 2, even. That's like undercosted by 1.5. So it's like you get excellent stats that are even crazier with... Or, oh god, even with 2. You could get 2 Valkyrie Spears as well. I don't even want to do the math on that. That's just terrifying. And then you get the Goblin King on top of it. Really good. I like that. I want more of these. I want more of these for my Nullcraft deck. Mask of the Black Death... Cool looking card. Snazzy hat and mask. Countdown 5. Whenever your leader takes damage, reduce the damage to 0 and subtract the same amount from this amulet's countdown. That is a Bloodcraft card. So, okay, I believe the intention here is to maybe prevent your self-damage effects. So you're preventing 5 damage. So, okay, so it still won't protect you from something like, whatever it's called, the card that, like, reduces you to 10 health. Because, yeah, this will block 5 of that. Oh, never mind. No, this blocks all of it. Okay. So you could, like, block lethal on this, potentially. Like for example, if they're sitting on, like, a rhinoceros combo. Or, I don't know, if they're able to hit... ping it down... Yeah, so yeah, you can defend yourself against big damage, like big damage with this card. Or if they've got like a Bahamut on the table and you've got no other options or anything, just Mask of the Black Death, your 13 damage reduced to 0. And yeah, it will prevent the 10 damage from that, what's his name, Soul Dealer, I think is the card. I don't even know what else it does, but I know it reduces your leader's health to 10. Or no, it reduces your health by half, that's right. Interesting. I'd have to look more into the Bloodcraft, like, self-damage cards to see if that's worth it, but... Oh, Phoenix Rider. Have we seen this? Oh, right, yeah, we've seen that one. And we've seen... Oh, we got an animated Goblin Princess. Kind of weak sauce. And that's that. No legendaries. Oh, well. We're going for our last 10. To be honest, I still kind of want to buy... I'm still going into the Darkness Evolved packs. I have, like... I bought, like, 80 of them so far, and I've got, like, no legendaries. I've got, like, 4 legendaries off of, like, 80 Darkness Evolved. I'd like to see Zeus out of this, too. Or, you know, just any legendaries, even. Support Cannon. 5 mana. Swordcraft. Whenever a commander is played, deal X damage to a random enemy follower. Oh, shit. Oh, shit! That's really good. That's insane. I mean, okay. Yeah, that's... It's like almost like giving them Rush. Except you can evolve them and still attack with them. like you put Albert down and he hits something... It's like you put your 9 mana Albert down and he hits something for 3. And then he hits something else for 3. And then or even 5 if you can do that. And then he hits something else for 5 or 3. Or you put down, like, any commander, and it deals that much damage. Insane. It's 5. 5 mana is a lot, so...
Fire! 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 Fire!
Oh, I never noticed that. That's new, or... Okay, I guess some of them don't have sound effects. I didn't think that you could, like, play the sound clip for amulets and spells before. I guess maybe just most of them don't have it. To be honest, I usually play the game with the volume off and just with music in the background. This is a new one. Forest Craft. 2/2. Okay, so it, like, gets double the evolved stats, but only if 3 cards were played this turn. But, you know, it's vanilla stat line. And, like, you don't have to play your 3 cards on the same turn you play this one, although you probably want to. I mean, that could be decent. Like, turn 5... 3 fairies and this thing, evolve it, and you've got a 6/6 on the table on, like, turn 5. Which is, you know, the turn where everything gets removed, but whatever.
Ready, set, go! Ayo!
Oh, I see how it works. So, like, she's small here, she's riding on the rabbit, and she's, like, the same size as, like, the bird's head. And then evolved, and yet she's got that mallet that, like, I forget what it's called, something in Japanese folklore changes the size of things, and now she's huge, and she's, like, bigger than the rabbit and the tiny little bird. That's just a neat little concept with, like, the artwork there. I love that.
I'm getting bigger!
No, they didn't change her voice. I thought it would have been cool if they changed her voice as well. Oh, wow, she has gotten bigger. Yeah, shit, the proportions aren't even the same. She's just like, whoa. Still, I don't even remember what the effect is, but I love the artwork. Frozen Mammoth, when you play a follower that... Okay, so neutral amulet gives you a mammoth if you play... Gives you a okay, not a free mammoth, but a 3-cost mammoth if you play a 7-cost dude. So it's like you play your Sahakwil to get out your, whatever, your Bahamut, remove something, or your Gilgamesh face damage, and then you get a mammoth on top of it instead. Beautiful. Yep, I like it. Bard, Mage, Lightning. This is like the 6th one of these, I swear to God. Ebon Reaper, that's a new one. Bane, last words, give Bane to a allied follower. It is Shadowcraft, it is 6-cost. That's not very good. It's kind of boring. I don't know. Seen those guys. Seen it. I recognize this artwork, but I don't know if I've seen what the card does. Give 2/2 to all other allied followers and give them ward, or give the officers ward rather. Okay, so this is like a super, what's it, mage commander? Staff commander? I can't remember. The 6-cost guy who gives everyone +1/+1. That I used to think that card was like the greatest thing. I put that in like all my Swordcraft decks and it was just amazing. Now nobody runs it anymore. It's just not a thing. And this guy's even more expensive, but the effect is way stronger. I don't know. It could be interesting. It's really strong if you can get like a full proc out of it until, you know, they just mass clear the thing with... And Dragon's got a mass clear now too, so... Although turn 8, so it'll be a couple turns till they get it out. Hey, another animated beetle. Beautiful. Assassin. Octobishop? Shit, where has this been all this time? I'm still seeing bronzes that I haven't seen yet. At the end of your turn, restore 3 defense to this follower. That is alright, I guess? So like you hit something with it and then it heals itself. It's basically like one of those cards that heals itself. Like what, Moon... Is that Moon L, what's her name, that heals back up at the end of the turn? This is basically that, except without Storm, which makes it bad. But, and for 4-cost, I think, I'm pretty sure Haven has better stuff at 4. Like, I would play the Veteran Tamer over this for sure, all the time. Wrath Drake, don't think I've seen... Oh, yeah, we have. Ooh, Legendary, Hulking Giant. Discard... Oh! Okay, so at 6-6 can't be... 6-6 untargetable is already pretty strong. And now instead of your traditional Earthrite, you discard the Earth Sigils from your hand, and it becomes insane. Wow. This is potentially really good. Like, really good for Dirt Rune. I mean, like I said, there's all sorts of untargeted removal out there these days. So, it's not invincible or anything. That's another card in this set that I have. I don't know if we'll see it. But, yeah. Yeah, that's definitely going right into my Dirt Rune deck. Murren Man, Murren, Dwarf, Werewolf. Are there just not as many cards in this set as the previous ones, or am I just getting, like, really unlucky? Or, okay, I got a full set of Luminous Mages now, so that's pretty lucky, I guess. Also got more of this one. I'd love an animated one of these. I think I want that more than I want another Legendary. I want an animated Sukuna. Jesus, well, I'm pretty sure we got just about a full set of bronzes at this point. Oh, is this new? Queen of Guldenia. Whenever it attacks, deal 2 damage to a random allied follower. Then 2 to your leader. And that's a Haven card. Okay, so 2 to your leader, you don't really give a shit because you're healing your leader all the time anyways. And you can heal your followers as well. It is what? It is basically undercosted by 1 for its stats. But the effect is kind of shitty. I don't know why you'd want this. And hey, we got another mask. Ooh, library, that sounds promising. Count down 2 at the end of your turn, put a random spell in your hand for 2? Hot damn! That's just, wow. That's just like an auto-include in every rune deck, I feel like. So you get two cards for two mana, and they're both guaranteed to be spells. That is insane. Yeah, every rune deck is running this, I think. I mean, you know, even Dirt Rune runs this, I think. Because, this will pull Calamitous Curse for you. Wow. Wandering Bard, Owlcat. Oh, this is a new one, too. Fanfare, summon two whites. That's... What's a white? Oh, right, yeah, the two-cost guy who... Yeah, deals damage to the... I mean, you get two of them, so you can, like, stack it up. Interesting. So this puts three dudes on the board. A lot of stats, too. So 4, 2, 2. So you get, like, what, 8, 7 worth of stats for 7 across three dudes, plus double damage on the enemy leader if anything dies. And when this thing dies, you get a white king. I don't know what that is. So it's... Okay, vanilla 4 drop, but Necromancy 4 buffs it up. And you get that for 0. For 0! So you can just play that right away. Oh no, that's last words. Yeah, last words. Even so, wow.
May you rot and decay.
That seems crazy good. Although, I don't know. Do you play it over Kawi is the thing. Probably not. Hey, Orthus, I don't think I've seen that. 2 damage to a random enemy, and then 2 to a random allied follower. I was assuming this was going to be Haven, but it's Shadow. 1, 2 for 4, though.
Orthrus has arrived.
That's a lot of stats, though. That's a lot of, like, transfer, though. And so, yeah, you're getting 2... Plus, you're getting 2 attack on one of your allies. And actually, it doesn't say another random allied follower, so it could be herself. So you're... Okay, so it's effectively overcosted by 1 stat-wise. You get a 3-2... Except the 2 of the attack goes somewhere else, potentially. Which could be good, actually. That's better than a 3-2, because the 2 could go on something that's on the board already, for example. So you could use it right away. And you get the 2 damage. So yeah, ping for 2. Put 2 extra attack. Yeah, that's actually quite solid. That's actually... I don't know why it's in Shadowcraft. Like, this could be... Or I guess it probably be... It even looks like a sword card. Yeah, why is this in Shadow? I don't know, but it's good, but yeah. Doesn't really just fit with the whole, like, Shadow thing. Hey, my second Blood Moon. That's nice. I think that's my second Aqua Nereid as well. Okay. We're over 90 minutes now, but God, I did not... That seems disappointing. I was hoping for more... Or okay, I guess what, we've opened 30 packs and got 3 legendaries. That's about average. Let's try for a couple more, though. Or one more, if we're lucky. Okay, Freshman Lou. Oh, hey, there it is. That's the card I was alluding to earlier. I'm so glad I did that. First off, let's go right to the thing, because this is the... Again, one of the first ones that was spoiled that everyone was talking about, because nobody understood what the hell this thing did. Can't be damaged, can't be affected by card abilities. It's 9 for an 8-8. And yeah, so they clarified this, and yeah, it's invincible. You literally cannot remove this. Like, nothing in the game can remove this. It's just you pay 9 mana, and it's there forever, and there's nothing you can do about it. I mean, you can reduce its attack, but... I don't even know what cards will do that enough to make a difference.
Righteousness. Heaven rebukes you. Judgment.
That's pretty badass. And again, it's like kind of one of those like late game inevitability, like inevitable win condition type things. Where it's like, yeah, basically, yeah, like a, not exactly a budget Seraph, but like an alternate Seraph. So it's like I can run like Seraph style decks. Or not, it's not even Seraph, really, because you don't need countdown reduction for this. That's the thing, you don't need any support with this. You don't need, like, your countdown reduction to make this work. You just drop it on the board on turn 9, and then you win 4 turns later if you survive, and they don't play enough stuff on the board that you need to control. Okay, it's not as amazing as it sounds, but it's still insane just that is in the game. Just a literally invincible dude. That's an 8-8. And then there's this thing. A random card with spell boost from your deck into your hand for 2. What the fuck? Okay, between this and the Luminous Knight, I feel that Runecraft and, like, that Rune and Sword, which are, like, kind of the two big classes right now, got, like, the most impactful cards. Like, between this and the Library for Runecraft, they're going to have a way easier time assembling their combos now. Like, this and the Library, I think, are just, like, strict, like, power cards that'll go into almost every deck. And then, what was it? And then Swordcraft got the Luminous, whatever it was. That's crazy good. And those are like the two cards I would say are like unambiguously like crazy good and will improve existing archetypes notably. And the archetypes that they're improving are the ones that are like the most prevalent already. I don't know if I like that. The rest of the set has been cool. I like a lot of what I'm seeing. It's tough to tell. Like, I don't know how any of this is going to shake up the meta or whatever. Like, a lot of this is just like, oh, that's interesting. That's a neat effect. We haven't seen it before. Maybe it'll work. But I don't see much that's like, there haven't been a ton of cards where it's like, oh, yeah, this fits into this archetype that wasn't doing well. Like, we saw the one discard dragon card, and that's like the only one we saw. So I guess thank goodness for that. But, and yeah, we got the Aegis. Okay. Just over 90 minutes. Let's take a look at everything we got. Tempest. Okay, let's clean up the chaff. Extras, please. Wow, that's a lot of duplicates. That is a lot of duplicates. Or actually, I'm curious. So what am I missing now? Okay, let's just go over the whole collection first. So we got this. So we got 7 pages worth of stuff to play with right now. Nothing super. Oh, okay. We got a couple. Like I said, I don't have any of like the good Control Haven cards. So between the Aegis and the Grail, I can kind of put together like a new. Oh yeah, this will be exciting to work with as well. I might craft another one of these to see what we can do with that. Elf Queen. Yeah, I guess we got 2 Forest Legendaries. Okay, now I'm curious. Which bronzes am I missing? Okay, looks like I probably got all the bronzes. Yeah, I don't quite have a full set, but yeah, I've got pretty much all the bronzes here. Silvers. Right, we got an animated Lou. Jolly Rogers, I don't think we saw. Random, okay, that's an interesting one. I wish we could have seen that. Okay, so we got basically all the silvers. Golds, we probably got a ways to go on those. Oh, not really. We're missing the Elder Mage, summon a dragon, or a Windblast. God, I swear to God, Rune is better. Rune can do better with the freaking Windblast dragons than the Dragons and Windblast Dragons than frickin' Dragoncraft can. And Soul Dominator Storm, whenever another follower, any follower is destroyed, gain 1. Yeah, of course, that's gotta be blood. That seems really good. I wish I could get one of those too. And it's gold. That seems like a legendary class thing. Looks like she's got a decent. See, this is the kind of like sexy lady stuff I was looking for, that I look for in my Shadowcraft cards. I wanna see her colored in. Man, come on. I mean, hell, she's only 800 craft. I got the Liquid Despair. Let's do it. There she is. I breathe life into you. What is this? What? I just blew up my microphone there. I saw. What the fuck is this? What is a Sirius Globe? You can craft animated cards now? Holy shit. Okay, I'm not going to do a whole overview of the expansion. I don't even know what else they added here. Anyways, this is just going to be like a pack opening and card overview. But yeah, wow, what the fuck? Okay, that's amazing. Wow, that's really exciting. So excited to craft all of the animated cards. And then yeah, legendaries. Legendaries are the ones that you that you hunt for in this game. Like, yeah, if you look at my current collection. Yeah, I ended up crafting my second dragon song flute, and I believe I crafted Pascal there as well. But yeah, I've got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, 6 on the Darkness Evolved. And I didn't get any of the good ones. Like, I want Odin, I want Olivia, and I kind of want Enstatued Seraph to play with that. Standard, I've got a decent set. And I got really lucky with the Bahamut legendaries. I got like, I swear to God, I've got like half as many, I've pulled like half as many Bahamut packs as I have of Darkness Evolved, and this is what I've got. Well, okay, I crafted the three Darias, but other than that, everything else I pulled from packs. I think I even got a fourth Bahamut at one point. Anyways, we're well over 90 minutes now. Yeah, that's been about 100 minutes of pack openings. And yeah, just my impressions of the new set and everything. Okay, actually, I'm gonna do another overview just to see if my intuitions are correct. Is there a sexy lady deficit in this pack? So far I'm gonna say yes. I'm not seeing a lot of skin here. She's all right, but the card is a bit dark, so the face is a bit derpy. She looks really good. I like this one a lot. The face, that's actually a fine face. Face is a little bit derpy if you evolve it, but I like the eye color at least. She's classy at least, but yeah, I'm just not seeing as much skin as I would like to see here. Yeah, she's got a nice butt there if you evolve it. Yeah. I don't know. Maybe they're responding to community feedback. Maybe there's a lot of Shadowverse players out there, or people who would get into Shadowverse that weren't down with the ladies, the anime ladies, like some of us. like your humble commentator here are. Soul Dominator is a good one. Yeah, she kind of... She got like crab legs, or she's got like... Yeah, it looks like crab legs or something for like leggings. It's weird looking. And yeah, that's basically it for like rampant like cleavage and butts and skin and stuff. I guess we got some thigh there, but yeah, kind of a letdown in that regard, I've got to say. Everything else is looking cool though. I'm really excited to play with some of this stuff. So in fact, yeah, I'm gonna go craft myself some decks. So I'm gonna sign off from here. If anyone actually did watch through this whole nonsense, thank you for watching. I will probably do some more Shadowverse stuff here on the channel if anyone does end up watching and enjoying this. I've been kind of mulling over whether I want to get into the whole, you know, game recording thing for Shadowverse. And yeah, I guess we'll wait and see on that. But until then, thanks for watching. And I'll see you guys next time.